Before proceeding to the experiments, we'll understand the theoretical background of this algorithm. So today we're going to study naive Bayes algorithm. We are going to cover the points like what is naive Bayes algorithm, how naive Bayes algorithm works, what are the pros and cons of using naive Bayes. Then we'll see some applications of naive Bayes algorithms and one example in detail how it will help us in classification. So first point is, what is naive Bayes algorithm? It is a classification technique based on Bayes theorem with an assumption of independence among predictors. In simple terms, a naive Bayes classifier assumes that the presence of a particular feature in a class is unrelated to the presence of any other features. For example, consider a fruit, maybe an apple, if it is red, around about 3 inches in diameter, then we can consider it as a fruit. Even if these features depend on each other or upon the existence of other features, all of these properties independently contribute to the probability that this is a fruit considered as an apple, and that is why it is also known as naive. The naive Bayes model is easy to build and particularly useful for very large data sets. Along with the simplicity, naive Bayes is known to outperform even highly sophisticated classification methods. So as compared to different classification methods, this is one of the simplest methods for classification. Bayes theorem provides a way for calculating the posterior probability, that is probability of C over X, from probability, individual probability of class C and the predictor X, probability of predictor X. And also we need to calculate probability of predictor for a class C. So we are going to use the equation of Bayes theorem to calculate the posterior probability by using the formula probability of C over X is equals to probability of X over C into probability, individual probability of C divided by individual probability of X. And these terms are also renamed, like if you see the left hand side of the equation, it is also known as posterior probability. P of X over C is called likelihood, whereas P of C, it is called as class prior probability, whereas P of X is called as predictor prior probability. So we'll see these terms in detail when we see an example. We'll understand all this. So what is this P of C over X? It is the posterior probability of class, that is C, that is our target, given predictor X, which is our attribute. P of C is the prior probability of class. Probability of C over X over C is the likelihood, is the probability of the predictor given class. P of X is the prior probability of the predictor. So these are certain terms we need to calculate to find out the posterior probability. So we need to calculate all these four terms to get the posterior probability. How does this naive Bayes algorithm works to predict or a sample belongs to a particular class? We use certain steps. Okay, let us understand it by using an example. Below, suppose I have a training data set of weather and corresponding target variable place. The play variables suggesting possibilities of playing. Now, we need to classify whether players will play or not based on the weather conditions. So weather conditions are given to us. That will decide whether the player will going to play the match or not. So the training data set is given to us in the exam. Let us follow the below step to predict or classify whether that particular player is going to play in a certain weather condition or not. So the first thing that we always do with the given data set is we convert the given data set into a frequency table. So if you consider this diagram, the left-hand side diagram is a table of a given data set. We have total 14 records here, and there are two columns, attributes you can say, weather and play. Okay. So in the second step, we create a likelihood table by finding the probabilities like overcast probability and probability of playing. So how these values will be calculated, that we'll see. First of all, according to step one, we will going to convert this table into a frequency table. So what do you mean by frequency table? Number of times yes or no is coming for a given weather condition. So here in the frequency table, we will list out the weather conditions like overcast, rainy, and sunny. There are three different possibilities for the weather. That is overcast, rainy, and sunny. Okay, we have taken it from this table only. For playing conditions, the possibility may be no or it may be yes. So probability of playing is maybe no or it may be yes. So we have two classes, suppose yes and no here. So we will look for overcast. We'll check the table and we will check all the records, all the samples for overcast weather. How many times the playing condition is yes? If it is yes, we will going to calculate the number of times yes is coming for overcast. So you see second record overcast, it is yes. Then we have next record here as overcast, yes. This is second time it is appearing, yes. And the third record is here, it is overcast, yes. And our second last record of the table is also yes. So there are four yes for the overcast. So I will write here for overcast weather conditions, probability of playing yes is four. Four times it is coming yes in the table. Whereas for no, when the weather condition is overcast, for playing conditions no, there is no record in the samples. So I will put zero here, or you can keep it blank, no problem. There is no overcast for no playing conditions. We'll put zero here. Now take the next weather condition, that is raining. Go into the table, check where is any weather conditions there, and check how many times it is yes and how many times it is no. So if you see the third record, rainy is the weather condition and play is yes. Again, check the next records. Here we found rainy, again yes. And the last record, rainy, no. So rainy, no is three. You can check the table. Rainy condition with yes probability two times, whereas rainy weather conditions with no as the outcome. So we have three. Three times no and two times yes for rainy conditions, weather condition. For sunny, it is no two times. You can check here first record and here is one. That is sunny and no. So we have two times no, whereas three times yes. Sunny, yes. Sunny, yes. And sunny, yes. So we have weather condition sunny over yes is three times. So we record all the possibilities of yes and no for all the weather conditions in this frequency table. Now if you add all this, grand total would comes total. If you add no, for no it is five, for yes it is nine, right? So number of times no coming in the entire table is 5, whereas number of times yes is coming is 9 times. So the grand total for no would be 5, whereas for yes would be 9. Now we are going to calculate the likelihood tables to find out the conditional probability of this. So we already obtained this frequency table. From that we are going to find out the likelihood table, which is how to write here. For overcast, when condition yes is there, the total probability of this likelihood probability becomes 4 by 14. Why it is 4 by 14? 4 times it is yes, whereas total number of samples is given to us were 14. Total number of records or samples is given to us in the data set was 14. That's why 4 by 14, that goes to 0.29. Similarly here, for raining, total would be, if you add this, total is 5 by 14, that goes to 0.36. Then for raining, it is again 2 plus 3 is 5, 5 by 14, again it is 0.36. Now for column side, if you are again calculate here, suppose for no's, how many times no is coming, how many times yes is coming, it for calculating individual probability of no and yes, it would be total is 9, total is 5, 5 by 14, 5 by 14 goes to 0.36, and yes is total yes is 9, 9 by 14 goes to 0.61. So it means we found the individual probabilities of yes and no's and the conditional probabilities of each weather conditions in the likelihood table. So these are the conditional probabilities of all the weather conditions, and these for column side, these are individual probabilities of no and individual probability of yes, that is 0.36 and 0.64 respectively. In step number 3, now we use the Naive Bayesian equation to calculate the posterior probability for each class. The class with the highest posterior probability is the outcome of the prediction. It means if you want to test any sample, whether that belongs to yes, class yes or class no, that would be decided by a class with the highest posterior probability to which the sample belongs to will go to that particular class. Okay. So let us take one example of a problem wherein we want to test to which this class this particular sample goes. Players will play if the weather condition is sunny. Player will play if the weather condition is sunny. Is this statement is correct? We'll check. Is this statement correct or not? Okay. To solve this, as I discussed before, we need to calculate some terms like which are needed to find the posterior probability of any sample. So we need to calculate all these terms, then only we can put the values in this formula and we can predict whether it belongs to the class yes or class no. Okay, so here players will play if the weather is sunny or not will be tested by using the formula. For that we need to first of all calculate the term probability of yes over sunny equal to probability of sunny or yes into probability of yes divided by probability of sunny. So if you put it into the formula, you will get this. Now we have to first of all find out probability of sunny over yes. What is that probability? Go and check into the table sunny and yes. Condition sunny in this likelihood table, sunny and yes, that is 3 here, sunny and yes. So that goes to 3 times it is coming yes, and there are 9 samples. Yes, total 9 samples. 9 times it is yes, right? So out of that 9 times yes, 3 is yes for sunny. So that total goes to 0.33. What is the individual probability of sunny? If you go to the given sample database, The individual conditional probability for Sunny is 5 by 14, and that is 0.36. We already calculated into the likelihood table. So we'll put it into the formula here. We found that probability of Sunny is 5 by 14 and it is 0.36. And what is the individual probability of S? Go and check into the table. Individual probability of S is 0.64. Just put it here. Probability of S is 0.64. Now we obtain all these probabilities. Just put it into above formula to get posterior probability of S or Sunny. So if you put all these values, just put it into the formula 0.33 into 0.64 divided by 0.36. You will get the final value as 0.60, which has higher probability. NeoBayes uses a similar method to predict the probability of different classes based on various attributes. This algorithm is mostly used in text classification and with problems having multiple classes. So here in our example, the result is yes, because it has highest probability. So we can say that the given statement is true. It is correct. Okay. To understand this NeoBayes example, we will see one more example. In your examination, they will going to give you a sample data set like this. Okay. So we have number of days as attribute, outlook, temperature, humidity, wind, and playing tennis. So these are the conditions we are going to decide whether the tennis match will be played or not. If the weather conditions suits, it is yes. If it is not, then it is no. So you can check the last column. Play tennis, sometimes it is yes, sometimes it is no. So these are the outcomes. So we have to decide. Now in your examination, they were going to give you one sample which is not available into the given training data set. So if it's this particular sample is not, the last line, you can check outlook equal to sunny, temperature equal to cool, humidity equal to high, wind equal to strong. This is not available into this training data set, and you just have to map this particular sample data set into a class yes or no, that is for playing a tennis match. Okay, so this particular data set has been given to us having 14 sample records into it, and one extra record that they have given to us, and our job is to predict that to which class this data set will be matched. It may be yes or it may be no. We'll apply the same steps again. From the given data set, training data set, we will first of all find out how many times in the last column it is yes or how many times it is no. Means we are calculating the individual probabilities of playing tennis over S is 9 by 14. You can check there are 9 times yes is coming. So 9 by 14 equal to 0.64. And how many times it is no? It is 5 times no. So 5 by 14, it is 0.36. So total 14 records, out of which 5 times it is no. That's why 5 by 14. So 0.36 is the individual probability for no. Individual probability for playing yes is 0.64. So we obtained the individual probabilities, and after that we have to find out the conditional probabilities over all the attributes for all the weather conditions like outlook, temperature, humidity, and wind. Let us focus on outlook as a attribute. The weather conditions are sunny, overcast, and rain. So again, the same thing we have to follow. For how many times the outlook is, outcome is yes for sunny, and how many times it is no. So if we scan the whole table, you will find there are 2 times yes. There are 2 times yes for sunny weather condition, whereas three times it is no. So that we will write here 2/9 for yes and 3/5 for no. So why it is 2/9? Because the outlook condition sunny over yes is 2 out of total 9 yes in the whole table. There are total 9 times it is yes, out of which 2 belongs to sunny. Similarly, out of 5 nines, 5 times no playing conditions, it is 3 times sunny. So it means outcome no over sunny over no is 3/5. 3 times it is no when the weather condition is sunny out of 5 no's. Okay. Similarly, if you check the outlook overcast, if you check the overcast in this table, how many times it is yes and how many times it is no, just find out. So it is 4 times yes. It is 4 times yes. So 4/9. Whereas there is no possibility for overcast. There are no records having no when the outlook condition is overcast. That's what is 0/5. 0/5 is nothing but 0 only. So we put 0 here. For rain condition, again check all the records and check how many times it is yes and how many times it is no when the weather condition is rain. 3 times it is yes and 2 times it is no. That's why we will write the conditional probability rain over yes is 3/9. Similarly, rain over no is 2/5. Now check the another attribute, that is temperature. Temperature is hot, mild and cool. There are three types of temperatures. So we will note down all. Again, for how many times when the temperature is hot over yes? If you check all the records, there are 2 times yes, whereas 2 times no for hot temperature. So we will write 2/9, whereas 2/5 for no. 2/9 for yes and 2/5 for no. Similarly, for mild temperature, how many times it is yes and how many times it is no? So 4 times it is yes, whereas 2 times it is no. So we will write the conditional probability of temperature mild over yes is 4/9, whereas no, it is 2/5. Similarly, for the another case of temperature is cool. For cool, how many times it is yes, and for cool, how many times it is no? 3 times it is yes, and 1 time it is no. That's why it is 3/9 and 1/5. We obtain all the conditional probabilities for another attribute, that is temperature. Now we'll do the same thing for humidity as the attribute, and wind is the next attribute. Humidity is high and normal only. So there are only 2 values. Humidity is high and normal. So how many times it is yes and how many times it is no for humidity high? So the conditional probability of humidity high over yes is 3/9. 3 times it is yes, whereas 4 times it is no. That's why 4/5 in the no column. Okay. Similarly, for normal humidity, yes is 6 times, whereas no is 1 time. So that's why we write 6/9 here and 1/5 in the no. For the last column, wind, we have 2 values, that is strong or weak. So how many times it is yes and how many times it is no, we'll get it from the training data set. So the probability of wind as strong over yes is 3 times and no is 3 times. So 3/9 for yes and 3/5 for no. For weak, it is conditional probability for weak over yes is 6 times and no is 2 times from this table. So we will write 6/9 for yes and 2/5 for no. So it means now we have obtained all the conditional probabilities for all the attributes given to us in the training data set. Now let us map the sample data set that they are given to us and predict which class it goes to. So the sample data set is outlook equal to S, outlook equal to sunny, temperature equal to cool, humidity is high, and wind is strong. For that, we are going to use the probability formula, posterior probability formula, is equals to ARGS max P of Vj into P of Ai over Vj. So what we are going to do here is, we will replace Ai and Vj here. Ai is your attributes, whereas Vj is the predictor, yes or no, right? Here we'll write P of outlook equal to sunny over Vj. Similarly, temperature over equal to cool over Vj. Humidity high over Vj and wind strong over Vj. From where these values are coming? From the given data set. So outlook sunny. So we'll put outlook sunny equal to sunny. Temperature equal to cool here. Temperature equal to cool. Humidity equal to high. We'll put it here. Wind equal to strong. We'll put it here. Now, how to replace this Vj in the formula? So we have to put Vj value is a class, right? Class values. It may be true or it may be false, or it may be yes or it may be. So we have yes and no as a class. So one time we'll put yes and we'll check the probability, and another time we'll put no into this formula for Vj and we'll try to find out the probability. So let us find the probability of yes, posterior probability of yes for this particular sample. So when we put it into this formula, so wherever Vj is there, I will put yes in the above formula, right? We put yes, and then we'll get the formula as individual probability of yes into conditional probability of sunny over yes, conditional probability of cool over yes, into conditional probability of high over yes, into conditional probability of strong over yes. So from where we'll get it, get these values? We can get these values from the above table, above step. So what is that sunny over yes? Sunny over yes is 2/9, correct? So here you can check. Conditional probability of sunny over yes is 2/9. Then cool over yes. So it is, you can get it from the another table, that is temperature table. Cool over yes is 3/9. So you can just these values. Similarly, high over yes, you can get it from third table, that is humidity. High over yes is 3/9. Probability of strong over yes, you can get it from the last table. Strong over yes is 3/9. When you put all these values here into the formula, and from where you get P of yes, it is individual probability of yes. It is 9/14, that is 0.64. When you put all these values into the formula, you will get the final value as 0.0053 for yes. And for no, again we put, use the same formula. Wherever Vj is there, you just put no into the probability formula. When you put no, it becomes individual probability of no into conditional probability of sunny over no, into conditional probability of P cool over no, into conditional probability of high over no, into conditional probability of strong over no. When you put these values from the above tables, you can get those values. Probability of individual probability of no is 0.36. And you can use this conditional probability values, that is sunny over no. Sunny over no, you can get it from this first row of the outlook table. Here it is 3/5, right? Sunny over no is 3/5. Next, cool over no. Cool over no is 1/5. High over no is 4/5. Strong over no is 3/5. You just have to replace these values here and find the product. You will get the result as 0.0206. So the probability of yes is more here. Sorry. The probability of no is more. If you check this output, the probability of no is higher than probability of yes. That's why this record will go into the class no. To get the actual value, probability, posterior probability of yes, you can use this formula. That is posterior probability of yes, the other posterior probability of yes plus posterior probability of no. If you put all these values here, you will get the normalized value for, yes, it is 0.205. Similarly, for no, you will have to replace it as by posterior probability of no divided by posterior probability of yes plus posterior probability of no. And you put all these values here, you get the normalized value as 0.795. And whether your result is correct or not, to check whether your result is correct or not, you just have to add these probabilities of yes and probability of no. Posterior probability of yes plus posterior probability of no, if it comes to 1, if you add these two values and if the result goes to 1, then the obtained values are correct. So here you can check from the result, the posterior probability for class no is higher than the posterior probability of class yes is here. That's why this particular sample given to us, that is outload equal to sunny, temperature equal to cold, humidity equal to high, wind equal to strong, goes to class no. It means the playing condition is no for these weather conditions. So this way we can classify any sample given to us by using Neo Bayes algorithm.